So how was episode 124?
While I do think it was better than 123, there are still a lot of issues, but we'll get into those in a second. First, let's talk about Goku and Chibi-Eyed Vegeta versus Jiren. But it's pretty cool seeing Goku and Vegeta pushing this guy back, because earlier on, you're like, how are they going to stop him? He's so unstoppable. His power is just unimaginable. But they push him back a little bit, and then they do this awesome final Kamehameha, even though it didn't combine, which I personally was a little bit disappointed in. I was like, oh, please combine again, you know, like we saw against the Trio de Dangers. But it didn't combine, but it still hit Jiren head on, and seeing the shockwave of it just shatter these mountains was freaking awesome. And Jiren is buried under this, and a pillar of light explodes from it, because you know Jiren's not beaten by that, you know? So he explodes the giant pile of boulders from under him, and they're like, oh man. And you see like this close-up of his face, freaking badass, and still giving me a little bit of the Terminator vibes, like I said in my last review. So really cool stuff, and I noticed when he lunged to attack, he actually like yelled out. I'm not sure if he actually has yelled at all while fighting. He usually just has his mouth closed, like he's hardly even trying. It looks like he's actually putting a little bit of effort into this. Very interesting. And he explodes this giant white light, and we see a really nicely done edit here of Dispo, and Frieza and Dispo are still going at it. Now, this is something that's kind of strange to me, is Frieza's power in his final form. Now, we saw earlier when Dispo was fighting Hit, he was damaging Hit, he wasn't as strong as Hit, but especially due to his speed, he was getting the upper hand on Hit, as well as Goku needing to go into his blue form to actually cause a lot of damage on him. So Dispo should be stronger than Super Saiyan God Goku, but weaker than Super Saiyan Blue Goku, which as we've seen in the past, Final Form Frieza is around base Goku level. So I really don't see how Frieza is really comparing himself to Dispo at all at this point. I really think he should have gone golden before this point, you know? It's a really mixed bag with how good this episode looks. A lot of reused animation, a lot of wonky looking shots, derp face, but then you have some really great looking shots and a really cool part of Dispo using the Galactic Donut on Frieza. I'm gonna call it the Blue Galactic Donut. So they're going at it back and forth. Dispo is about to hit Frieza. He catches his arm with his tail and starts crushing his arm. And I'm like, why is that hurting you, dude? Anyway, does Dispo's power make sense to anybody? Let me know in the comments. To me, it doesn't quite add up. But now we get to the proposal. Frieza proposes to Dispo, hey man, we are just going back and forth here. How about I help you guys defeat Universe 7 if you promise to revive me with the Super Dragon Balls? Which I am actually very glad that Dispo didn't go against his ethics and morals of being a pride trooper to let this evil guy betray his own team and stuff like that. And he's like, no way, I'm not gonna agree to anything from an evil guy like you. And Frieza's like, that's too bad. And then he goes golden finally. Which begs the question, why did Frieza feel the need or want to propose this idea to Dispo to betray Universe 7? The only reason I can think of is so that he would have, I don't know, a reason to eliminate Goku, Vegeta, and Gohan. That's the only reason, but they didn't say why he felt the need to do that, because then he would be training Goku's promise of reviving him to a promise from Dispo that they would revive him. So is he not believing Goku would revive him or bring him back to life? Who knows? Very strange. It felt kind of pointless to me, this whole proposal thing with Dispo. What did everybody think of it? It was like, in Frieza's character to be conniving and everything like that, it just didn't really add up to anything at all, at least not yet. Frieza proceeds to completely annihilate Dispo. And it's interesting seeing the worry in the Supreme Kai of Universe 11. Cool stuff, a lot of really great reactions from the audience here, but Dispo powers up. He gets this awesome, like, purple aura, and then he slaps aside one of Frieza's attacks, really cool effect showing his speed, going around Frieza and hitting Frieza and everything like that, pushing him back. And really dumb scene, a really, really long scene, actually. They focused way too long on this. And Zeno's like, huh? I can't see what he's doing over there, huh? Because I'm the king of all, I can't see fast speeds. I'll use this technology to see for me. And they still can't see, and that is how fast Dispo is going. Why didn't he do that against Hit? But who knows, that's up in the air. What do you guys think? Do you think if Dispo did this earlier on, do you think he could have eliminated Hit? But Frieza is in trouble. Even Beerus yells out, Frieza! And Gohan hears him and he's like, 17, you know, 17 was handling Topo by himself already. So Gohan goes to help Frieza. And now we get a pretty badass team up with Frieza and Gohan. And what made me really happy is that they still couldn't tag Dispo, but Gohan, being the brain that he is, finally comes up with a plan, and Frieza acknowledges his leadership, is acknowledging him as the leader and saying, okay, I'll follow your plan. And it's an awesome plan too, because they can't tag this guy because he has too much room to move around. So he has Frieza create a cage of death beams to kind of limit Dispo's movements. And this is like an awesome cage match in the Tournament of Power. It's like a little cage match within a tournament, you know? And Dispo gets hurt when he backs into one of the death beams. Awesome Gohan stuff here. But it shows that Frieza is having a hard time keeping this death beam cage going. So a little bit of foreshadowing what's about to happen. But Gohan one-on-one now with Dispo is starting to defeat him. Now this is some badass Gohan. Actually, speaking of badass Gohan, right before he jumps in to fight Dispo in the Cage of Death Beams, Frieza's like, how do you know I'm not gonna betray you? And Gohan's like, so badass. If you betray me, I'll be the one to eliminate you. Oh man, good stuff. Tiny moments like that make things so much better. So, Gohan's beating Dispo and everybody's yelling at Gohan. They're like, go, Gohan! And he goes in for one final punch, but Frieza loses his stamina with the death beams and Dispo dodges his punch and you're like, oh my god! There's so much tension. And you're like, oh no, Dispo's gonna punch Gohan! But no, Gohan freaking grabs him in like a full Nelson type lock. I don't know what you call it, but it was awesome. And he's like, Frieza, do it now! Do it now! Get to the chopper! And we should know that Frieza is not going to hesitate in eliminating one of his own teammates to eliminate a common enemy. Just like Gohan hesitated to eliminate 17 and Topo at the same time. So Frieza loses his stamina, quote unquote. While watching this, I'm like, okay, it looks like he's really hard pressed to keep this death beam cage going. Now, he could legitimately be losing his stamina and unable to keep it going, or what if he's faking? What if this guy has come up with some sort of plan and knows that Gohan is going to sacrifice himself to defeat Dispo? And so Frieza's like, oh, I can kill two birds with one stone here and eliminate both of these guys, this Saiyan kid that I hate and this guy Dispo who's giving me a tough time. What do you guys think? Do you think Frieza purposefully stopped his death beam cage? Comment what you think in the comments. So Gohan's elimination, this is okay for me. I feel like he got enough badassness in the tournament. I do feel, however, that it could have been done a little bit better, especially in terms of like pacing, I guess you could call it, because what happens is Gohan has Dispo and it shows Frieza blasting an explosion and then cuts to Zeno and then cuts to Gohan appearing on the bleachers. We didn't get a lot of drama because of that kind of editing and that kind of pacing. It kind of just like cut out, you know, Gohan's reaction to getting blasted, Dispo's reaction to getting blasted, them actually falling off the stage. I feel like there could have been like a couple more shots showing some reactions from everybody, showing a reaction from Gohan and Dispo. I feel like could have like amplified exponentially the drama of what was going on. So as far as the way he went out, I thought it was excellent. I thought Gohan sacrificing himself to get rid of such a dangerous opponent in Dispo. Like, this guy's way too fast. How can they possibly, you know, eliminate him? Because he's just gonna dodge everything, you know? Furthermore, you have Jiren and Topo to deal with on top of that. So now you're bringing the table to 2, Topo and Jiren against 4, 17, Frieza, Goku, and Vegeta. And Piccolo even says, "You made the right choice, Gohan. Good on you." That being said, I do feel that they focused entirely too much on Frieza versus Dispo in this episode and should have given the focus a lot more to Gohan. Furthermore, I would have liked a lot more of Gohan's shine in this tournament. Of him maybe fighting more built-up characters. Because he's eliminated people here and there, but most of them weren't really built up prior to the episodes that they were in. And it would have been nice to have the focus more on Gohan in this episode, as well as have his elimination in a better quality episode. And even further, they had a huge numbers advantage over these three Universe 11 guys. Part of me feels that Frieza and Gohan could have kept up the fight with Dispo until the very end of the tournament without getting eliminated. So, really cool stuff. A lot of reuses of animation. Didn't look the best, looked better than last episode. And it looks like 125, the next episode, is going to look even better than this. So the focus is mainly on Topo here. It's called God of Destruction Topo. So is he actually going to become a God of Destruction? Very interesting. Or is his power and aura going to be similar to a God of Destruction, you know, like God of Destruction tier amount of power or something like that, you know? And we see Topo pushing 17 back and then Frieza blasting. Does Frieza save 17 or is he too late to save 17 and has Topo eliminated Android 17? We'll have to find out in the episode. It looks like 17 is getting eliminated by Topo here, or maybe Frieza. But of course, we won't know until the episode airs, so let me know what you thought of episode 24. I thought it was okay. I thought it was really cool fights and stuff like that. Not the greatest looking. I felt like some of the elements could have been better, such as Gohan's elimination. But overall, I really enjoyed the episode. I thought it was cool. So as always, thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. Take it easy.